Welcome to the video on basic subtraction. Let's do a little bit of review of basic addition first. If I said 4 plus 3, what did this mean? 4 plus 3. What did that equal? Well, there were a couple of ways we could have viewed this. We could have said I had 4 of something. Let's say I had 4 circles, or I don't know, I had 4 lemons for breakfast. So 1, 2, 3, 4 lemons for breakfast. And let's say I had another 3 lemons for lunch. 1, 2, 3. And so you could view 4 plus 3 as how many total lemons did I have? I'm adding 3 to 4. So how many total did I have? Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I had a total of 7 lemons. Another way we could have viewed that is we could have drawn our number line. And I'll draw it in yellow because we're, no, that's not wide enough. I'll draw it in yellow because we're talking about lemons. So let's say that's our number line. And if I start at the number, let me draw all of the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you could think about this as saying, well, we're on the number line. We start at the number 4, right? That's this number 4. And we're adding 3 to it. So we'll increase along the number line by 3. So we'll go 1, 2, 3. And you end up at 7. So you could say, if I have 4 and I get 3 more, I get 7. Or if I increase 4 by 3, I also get 7. So what's subtraction now? Because that's what this video is about. I shouldn't waste all of our time talking about addition. So let's take the example of 4 minus 3. What is that equal to? Let me switch colors just to keep things interesting. So what is 4 minus 3 equal to? Subtraction, or minus, is the opposite of addition. So in addition, you're doing something more. You're adding. I don't want to use the word adding to define addition, but that's what you're doing. I had 4 lemons, and then I had 3 more. In subtraction, you're taking away. So this example, if I started with 4 lemons, let's say I had 4 lemons on a plate, if I'm subtracting 3, if I'm saying minus 3, instead of adding these 3 here and getting 7, I'm going to take 3 away. So maybe I'm eating them, or maybe I'm giving them to you for in exchange for watching these videos. So to take away 3 from this 4, let's say this one goes away, and this one goes away. How many lemons would we have left? Well, this is the only one that I haven't crossed out, so we would have 1 lemon left. 1 lemon left, and this would be the lemon that's left. Didn't have to be that one. I could have crossed out any of the 3. Another way to view that, let's draw the same lemon-colored number line. Say that this is the number line right here. And I'll draw all the same numbers. So that's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Of course, the number line keeps going. There's no largest number, you can imagine. Any number that you can think of, I can think of one higher than that. So there is no largest number, so that's why we draw that arrow there. I could never draw the entire number line. But anyway, back to subtraction. So we're starting at 4 lemons, right? When we added 3, plus 3, we went to the right 4 spaces on the number line. And that's because the right is increasing value. So we went from 4 to 5, that was 1 more, 5 to 6 was 2 more, and 7 was 3 more. Now we're taking away from 4. So what do we do? What would you think we do? Well, since we're taking away, we're going to decrease the total number of lemons we have, right? So we take away 1, we get to 3, take away 2, get to 2, take away 3. We took away 3, right? So we'll go back 1, 2, 3 along the number line, and we'll end up at 1. And that's this one right here. So just to review, addition is you're doing more of something. Subtraction is you are taking away. If you think about it on the number line, addition is increasing along the number line by that amount. So in this case, we increased along the number line by 3. And so we went from 4 to 7. In the subtraction case, we decrease back on the number line. So we decrease by the amount that you're subtracting. So in this case, we decreased by 3. So we went back 1, 2, 3, and we had 1. And the other way to view it, if I have 4 or something, if I give 3 away, or if I ate 3 of them, or if I don't know what I did to 3 of them, if I lost 3 of them, I would have 1 left. Now let me show you some interesting things about subtraction. So we know that 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Let me show you something else that's interesting. What is 4 minus 1? Well, we could use either example. Let's do the lemon example. Let's do apples now. I'm bored of the lemons. Let's say I had 1, 2, 3, 4. I have a new pen. Sometimes it doesn't draw right. Let's say I had 4 apples, right? This is the example we're dealing with. And I were to eat one of them. So one of them were to go away. How many apples would I have left? Well, 3. 1, 2, 3. So 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. And if we did it on the number line, if we started at 4, and we subtracted 1, we took 1 away, so we're going to become 1 smaller. We go back 1, we get 3. Either way works. But isn't this interesting? 4 minus 3 is equal to 1, and 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. That you might say, well, is this, you know, did I pick the numbers just so it worked? Well, it turns out that it's always true. I don't want to get too technical, but this is, we're already touching on stuff, something that you'll learn later on, maybe in algebra one day. But actually, I don't want to go into that right now. So where does this come from? Well, this is also based on the fact that 3 plus 1, I didn't want to confuse you, so I apologize if I did. But I'll show you another interesting thing. What is 3 plus 1? 3 plus 1 is equal to what? Well, that's easy. You know that from basic addition. You can start on the number line at 3 and add 1 to it. And where do you end up? You end up at 4. 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. Or you could have started at 1 on the number line and added 3. 1, 2, 3. And you would have also ended up at 4, right? So we also know that you could have switched this either way. Both of those are equal to 4. What do you see here? Well, there's a bunch of things I've written here, and they all kind of relate to each other. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. Essentially, 4 minus 1 and getting 3 is the exact same. You're saying the same thing as 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, right? This statement says, if I add 1 to 3, I get 4. This is saying, if I take away 1 from 4, I get 3. So if I start at 4 and move back, I get 3. This is saying if I start at 3 and I move up 1, I get 4. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of intuition about what subtraction is. In the next video, I'll just do as many basic subtraction problems I can do in 10 minutes, and then you'll be ready to do the exercises. See you soon.